Thank you for joining Share the Wealth. This is Kieran, and today we'll be talking about Tesla. Giga Shanghai has been hiring designers and factory workers in a recent push as the Model Y facility becomes close to being finished. An uncounted number of designers, as well as over 1,000 factory workers, will be hired in the next coming days. 600 will be hired in just stamping and bodywork, as well as solar and energy managers will be hiring in the next few weeks as well. They are looking for a new team to build as the Giga Shanghai factory comes to a more mature level. Gigafactory Austin is already in full swing as they began preparing the foundations to be laid. Gigafactory Texas will be, by landmass, the largest factory that Tesla has built to date. It is 6 times larger than Gigafactory Shanghai. How long it will take to prepare the factory is anybody's guess. It depends on American fabrication. In Shanghai, their advantage was a large number of workers building 24/7 and allowing a rapid construction of the factory itself. Berlin, however, has prefabrication and prepared materials and organization on their side. While they do not have the lax labor laws like China, their attention to efficiency has given the pace of Gigafactory Berlin an unforeseen advantage by many, as most did not think that they would be able to produce a factory on the same time scale as the Chinese. Where Tesla Texas and its Gigafactory near Austin come into play on that time scale currently is anybody's guess. Unfortunately, American regulations and its attention to efficiency is not known to be on the standard of the Germans or the Chinese. But will and ingenuity may prove everyone wrong. In other news, the S&P 500 inclusion will not happen overnight. The uncannily large market cap that Tesla has accrued will make it difficult for Tesla to be included into the S&P 500. It will displace many other equities and will inherently cause a large amount of disruption. Its inclusion is inevitable, however, it could take much longer than some people realize. The stock, however, has rebounded off the 1300 level and is in the 1500 range as of July 27th. If it does retrace to the recent lows, I predict a strong repurchase as buyers flood in to get what they deem as a good price before the S&P inclusion. Tesla bears Gordon Johnson and Jim Chanos have given their 2 cents, as both disagree and agree on what harms Tesla in the near future. Gordon Johnson thinks that the energy credits are fraudulent and they are doing some accounting mysticism in order to gain near-term profits. However, Jim Chanos is under the impression that deliveries are the reason for the accounting inadequacies.